Hello. We're doing the last division for the NFL season predictions. The way we do it is I give a rating of a series of 1 through 4, and I assign a trigger to each number. 1 is the globe, 2 is the beep and the click, and 3 is water, and 4 is a sniff. 1 is likely to lose the game, 2 is a toss-up, 3 is likely to win the game, and 4 is, I guarantee they'll win. I give them a 0 if I think they have no chance. I rarely think that they have no chance. This is the last division. I'm going to go through this a little bit faster than the other ones, probably. We're going to start off with Seattle. I'm going to give them a 2 and a loss. Tennessee. Next week is at home versus Tennessee. I double checked all of my work prior to this. I'm not going to double check it now. I'm not going to go back before I do the thing with Jigger. And a W. Minnesota, I'm going to give them a 2 and a loss. At San Francisco, I'm going to give them a 2 and a loss. At home versus the Rams, I'm going to give them a 2 and a W. At Pittsburgh, I'm going to give them a 2 and a W. And I'm pretty sure I gave them a 2. At New Orleans, I'm going to give them a 3. At home versus New Orleans, I'm going to give 3 and a W. Home versus Jacksonville, I'm going to give them a 3 and a W. Seattle's team as a whole, their defense looks questionable, their secondary is majorly questionable, their linebacking core is okay, their defensive line, I can't really name anybody right off the bat, off the top of my head. I'm forgetting. It's exactly questionable, other than, like, I know Bobby Wagner. They lost at a corner I liked. Diggs, I think, plays for them. I'm forgetting somebody. But their offense is obviously phenomenal because Russell Wilson and DK Metcalf and Tyler Lockett and Chris Carson, they just need an O-line. That's what they need. They need an O-line and a defense, and the whole defense. That's why I'm like, I don't know, Seattle. At Green Bay, I'm going to give them a 1. Home versus Arizona, I'm going to give them a 2 and a W. At Washington football team, I'm going to give them a 2 and a loss. At home versus San Francisco, I'm going to give them a 2 and a W. At Houston, I'm going to give them a 2 and a W. Actually, no, what am I saying? A 3 and a W. Los Angeles Rams, I'm going to give them a, who am I going to give them? 2 and a W. My hair's a wreck today, by the way. So, sorry. Sorry, I'm going to give them a 2 and a loss. I'm speaking out of my mind. Chicago, home versus Chicago. I think it's a 2 and a W. bunch of twos that finished it off. I'm gonna actually, it's the Houston. This is for the rest of them. Okay. 36 on my rubric. I do not think Seattle is this good, but I have them going 10-7. Okay. I had the same issue with another team I had, but that might be some bias, but Seattle would probably not. Next, we have San Francisco.
San Francisco 49ers.
We had the at Detroit, that's a 3 and a W. And Philadelphia, it's a 3 and a W. Green Bay, at home, it's a 2 and a loss. At home versus Seattle, it's a 2 and a W. At Arizona, a 2 and a loss. At home versus Indy, it's a 2 and a W. At Chicago, 2 and a W. I'm going to rectify retrospectively, give the at home versus Green Bay a 1. Okay, at home versus Arizona, 2 and a W. At home versus the Rams, 2 and a W. Jacksonville Jags, 2 and a W. Minnesota, 2 and a W. At Seattle, a 1 and an L. Cincinnati, 2 and a W. I think, yeah, it's between a 2 and a 3. I'm doing it. It's a 2. Screw it. It's a 2. It's a 2. At home versus Atlanta, it's a 2 and a W. At Tennessee, that's a 2 and a W, I think. Yeah. Houston, 4. Los Angeles Rams, it's a, I'm gonna give them a 1. And a loss. So now let's do some math. have them going. I have them going 13-4.
With a score of, with a lower score than the Seahawks of a 35. Maybe I'm just tired. Who knows? Moving on to the
Los Angeles Rams. Los Angeles Rams. Los Angeles Rams. Los Angeles Rams.
At home versus Chicago. That's a 3. Any W. At Indianapolis. I think I gave the W. And if not, I should have. Yeah, I should have. Two and a loss. At home versus Tom Brady, a 2-loss. At home versus Arizona, a 3-W. San Francisco's team as a whole is very good. San Francisco, their defense is strong, and this the linebacking core, their defensive line is also pretty darn good. Their defensive, their secondary is questionable, but like not bad. Their offense. The offensive line is substantial, solid. The receiving core has a lot of potential. Quarterback room has a lot of potential with Trey Lance. And the running back room is talented as any of the leagues with Trey Sermon, Raheem Mostert, and there's always somebody else in the backfield with Shanahan that he just like makes look so good. Now back to the Los Angeles Rams, which have Jalen Ramsey and Aaron Donald, two of the best defensive players of the past decade. Their defense is going to be good because they have those guys and they know how to scheme around it. Well, at least Brandon Staley did a good job, so maybe it's not going to be as good, but it should be good. So then we got. Their linebacking core is kind of questionable, but like not that bad. Their offense, Matthew Stafford at the helm, should be good. They have quality receivers, no one like world ending, but like quality. And Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods, both like underrated. They're both really good. Higbee's good. I think he's still there. Their running backs always get hurt there. That's the thing. And their offensive line's okay though. At Seattle, 2-loss. At the New York Giants, 2-dub. At home versus the Detroit Lions, 2-AW. At Houston, 3-AW. At home versus Tennessee, 2-loss. At San Francisco, 2-loss. At Green Bay, 1-loss. home versus Jacksonville. That's a 3.
And a W.
At Arizona, a 2 and a loss. At home versus Seattle. A 2 and a W. At Minnesota, a 2 and a W. At Baltimore, a 2 and a loss. At home against San Francisco, a 3 and a W. I have them scoring a 39 on my rubric. Which is a higher score than both San Francisco and Seattle, and that's a lower record projection than both of them with a 9 and 8. Maybe my brain's just broken. I think it's 100% proof that I need a new rubric for the next year, and I think I've already figured out how I'm gonna do that. But we're gonna finish what we've done three first out of 3 seconds. We're almost to the finish line. We're going to go and just finish it. You know what I mean? Moving on to the Arizona Cardinals. 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 You heard it. At Tennessee, that's a 2 and a loss. At home versus Minnesota, what did I give them for? A 2 and a W. At Jacksonville, a 2 and a W. At the Los Angeles Rams, a 1 and a loss. I'm gonna finish this real fast. San Francisco, that's a home 2 and a loss. At Cleveland, that's a 1 and a loss. At home versus Houston, that's a 3 and a W. Home versus Green Bay, that's a 2 and a loss. At San Francisco, that's a 2 and a loss. At home versus Carolina, I think that's a W. Let me double check what I give Carolina here. Yeah.
Chicago. At Chicago. I'm sorry. That's for Houston. I'm not sure if I do that. They were at home versus the Los Angeles Rams. And I'd say 2. NAW. Two and a W for at Detroit. At home versus Indy. Two and a L. Two and a W and then at home versus Seattle. 2 and a W. Okay, let's do some last math. They got a 33 in the rubric and okay. Now to recap the NFC West, the Arizona Cardinals. Wow, I'm not sure. I exactly thought it would work out like this. Yeah, I can't say I thought it'd work out like this. But here we are. The Arizona Cardinals and the Los Angeles Rams are going to tie with 9-8 record. So that's tied for third in place in the division. And then second place in the division belongs to the Seattle Seahawks, which is going to be a 10-7 record, which scored 36 points on my rubric. Arizona scored 33 and the Rams scored 39. That gives them the technical third place in my scoring. And moving on to the first place is the San Francisco 49ers with a 13-4 record. That's your NFC West for you predictions. Recap will be shortly. Thank you for watching. I've procrastinated on these long enough. Zoomed through this last one, I can't lie to you, but we're gonna do a recap as well. Thank you for watching. Sweet dreams. Happy football.